Emergency. 10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Oh, this is going to be sad. I'm going to die. Okay, well, according to this, hopefully the mic is on. This is going to be my first attempt here at creating a Let's Play. As a matter of fact, my first attempt at creating a video on a gaming series at all. So, hopefully this goes good. I'm going to be doing, of course, as you can see here, Subnautica. Yes, it is still in free access. Here, so they did add a few new things. I looked around for some vids. Haven't seen anybody talk about any of the new patches, I should say, or add-ons to the game. I'm probably wrong. There are a lot of things out there, but let's see how this goes. I've already messed around with the first scene and all. I like that they added. I wish they had a little bit more, but it adds on to the mystery. But I'm going to go with the new one. Let's see here. We're not going hardcore. I will die very quickly, and I don't think that would do too well for a Let's Play. Freedom sounds interesting, but too easy, and of course creative. Well, why am I doing a Let's Play if I'm going to be creative? So let's go for survival. Now, like I said, they did add some new stuff to the game. We'll see a little bit, hopefully, fairly soon. I might end up doing some editing and cutting this out. If the load time is ridiculously long.
Attention.
There we go. Okay, so as you can see, we've got a new beginning. Instead of going heading straight to waking up.
Launch in 3, 2,
little launch sequence, you know. Start of how what happened. Sort of. I mean, we still don't know, you know, why the ship blew up. Haven't gotten that far in the game, so I don't know if there's anything inside your main ship. Well, I'm surprised that didn't kill you. But at any rate, a little more interactive and whatnot at the beginning than before, because you're life pod is now on fire instead of just waking up. Like I said, I have played this before, so go ahead and put this out and bury it before I die. There we go. Now, that's the only time I've used the fire extinguisher.
Greetings, survivor. Great job not dying. To assist you in further survival in emergency situations, you have been issued this personal data assistant. The interface visible now will organize your inventory, display currently available construction blueprints, and holds other valuable information. Please take a moment to familiarize yourself with it.
Well, I guess I will. Like I said, that's... Well, I mean... It's the first time I've, and the only time I've used the fire extinguisher where it was useful. I don't know if any other fires occur. I know that your vehicles can see damage, etc. Don't know if the fire extinguisher can be used or would be needed after this one incident so far. Of course, right here you have your inventory, your equipment. This obviously the main screen that starts you off there. You've got your blueprints, kind of gives you a little bit of things to look at. Tells you, you know, obviously a little bit further down in red, because I haven't really gotten anything yet, obviously, what you need. Very helpful, especially if you're wandering around in the ocean. You know, like, well, I was trying to get that. What did I need to get? Your log, well, obviously, you know, what's happened. I mean, unless you stop playing for a while, which does happen, and you start back up, it's kind of just there. Photo albums, well, obviously, screenshots. Data bank, let's see here. Oh, okay. Well, it looks like it gives you some information on a little bit of your background. Oh, that's pretty neat. But at any rate, now, this, like I said, not going to be using. Got a little storage here.
Attention, detecting increased local radiation levels. Trend is consistent with ongoing degradation of the Aurora's dark matter drive core due to damage sustained during collision.
Now, of course,
continuing to monitor
the Aurora that's talking about is the main ship, and I'll get out and show you where it is compared to where you are. As you saw, I opened a little bitty storage container that you're automatically given. Beforehand, you used to get a lot more stuff in here. This time around, they gave you some food and some water. Don't remember if that was there before. I remember had some problems starting beforehand. Haven't used any flares yet in my previous play, but I figure I might as well grab it just in case. Obviously, you can see I am already a little bit hungry. Tells you what your right mouse buttons do. Obviously, I'm hungry, so you need that. Let's see here. There is also, there it is. Get a first aid kit beforehand. That would be just empty and useless. Don't think you can put the first aid kit back in there. This right there is a fabricator, which is what you use to turn your materials into other useful materials. We'll be going down and grabbing materials in a minute. Obviously, I don't have anything on me, so it's kind of useless. You have two options. You can go either down or up. Let's go up. Now there's the ship that you jettisoned from. If you start swimming in that direction, you will start getting warning signs, and it'll start telling you that, well, you will die if you get too close, basically. But at any rate, nice sky. I don't remember seeing flying things before. That's interesting. Okay, I'm gonna stop it. That moon's going by too fast. You can either jump in or obviously go back and then go back up the bottom. I'll just jump in. Okay. Obviously, you've got your O2 meter on the bottom there at the top of the list. Then after that, there's how much health you have. After that's your food, and then below that, very bottom, is your water. Obviously, you don't want to let any of that drop to zero. You die. Used to be when you died, well, at least by oxygen deprivation, you spawn back in your little world.
Emergency. 10 seconds of oxygen
and of
remaining.
Course, yeah, it's got the warning. But you used to spawn into your life. I don't know what happens now. Well, obviously I learned my lesson first. These guys are chill guys. I leave them alone. They're kind of big. Well, they'll attack you if you try messing. I prefer just that they hurt, and they fart, like, I don't know what they do. They have gaseous things, and they fart, hurt you. Okay, let's see here, so we're gonna Rick collects material, got some crystals here. I believe this turns into glass. We're also going to need to be collecting food and anything else while we're down here. This is mushrooms, acid mushrooms. Oh, I forgot to mention, you can dig in this game. Let's see.
Emergency. 10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
You can see my little hole that I dug there. One of the first things I'm going to be building is probably an oxygen pack. Just so I can last longer under the water. Got some copper out of that one. The game does have little health things, but they don't stand out much. Unless you're paying attention, well, you can easily not notice them. Oh, wow. I love the new salt texture. Beforehand, it was really hard to notice the salt. Or at least on my system it was. I could not tell it apart from the regular ground without looking with a flashlight. I think they need a knife. I love how everything at night starts to turn different colors and glow.
Caution. Continued degradation of the Aurora's drive core may cause a quantum detonation. Calculating risk assessment. Death by malnourishment, 7%. By physical injury, 11%.
Yes, it's
by
exposure kind of dark.
To radioactive crash site materials, 19%. If the drive core is breached, probability of death increases to 65%.
Yeah, like I said,
new creature discovered.
Game is kind of dark. It likes to tell you
how creature discovered.
How you're gonna die? Well, different ways there. These guys you can use to turn
new
water.
Creature discovered.
Very, very, very nice to find. Good to find their spawning ground.
Emergency. 10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Ah, here we go. This is the things I need. This, that'll turn into your, different metals. You can also find metals like I should before mining, but the mining sites aren't as pronounced as oh dang. Yeah, see that green area over there? Yeah, stay away from that. At least when you first start out. Those guys come out.
Emergency.
Those guys
10 seconds
and
of oxygen
and still, well, he's actually going after other fish, but, as you can see, he will chase you down and eat you, and I don't have a knife, so I can't do anything but run like chicken, and climb into my little body hole in here until he, decides to go back into his spawning ground. I guess now's the perfect time to come into here. Of course, you've got your sustenance area, food and water. And now that we have some food and water, or food and things to turn into water, we can go ahead and do that. Now, the air sac, well, let me get out of this and show you here. Air sac, where is that little guy? Here he is. When I was talking about earlier, you can turn them in either food or water. So he's very useful. He is, well, so far the best thing that I've found because of how diverse he is. Later on, when we put together some fish tanks and whatnot, we'll be looking for him a lot to put into the fish tanks. The reason why you use a fish tank is to put these guys in while they're still alive, because once you cook them, except for turning them in water, but once you cook them, they'll start to decay and turn bad, and their stats will go down. Right now, they're, well, still alive on me. I don't know how long you can keep them on you or store them in this manner. And I just ate one by accident because I wasn't paying attention and left clicked. Obviously, you can't eat them raw. They will give you stat, at least a food stat boost. But if you're underwater, well, you're screwed because, as you can see there, it says H2O minus 3. That will obviously deplete your oxygen. So your left case, which is a container. Well, it looks like you can store them. We'll leave that little guy there and see how long he lives in that storage container. I'm guessing not too long. So, like I was saying, water is a thing on our bar that goes down the quickest. So, we, instead of cooking our last little guy that we collected, and there are two ways of cooking. There is cured food, which you will cure that animal, or cooked food, which in his case doesn't matter, but I believe, or is it the other way? Oh, no, I got it the other way. Cooked food, you can cook them, and it's just what they are, is a recipe. Cured food turns them kind of like a jerky, so you need to pick up salts. Salts you can find randomly throughout the seabed, on the top, closer to the surface of the ocean, I guess I could say. Trying to go around finding that stuff sometimes is a little hard. You saw the texture pack they use, which is way better than it was before, but it's a little bit hard to see. Now, we'll go with the filtered water. It's the lowest form of water that you can get. If I mouse over it, you can see H2O gives you a 6 ounce pure bottle, whereas disinfected water gives you a 12
warning,
ounce.
Local radiation readings exhibit characteristics consistent with total degradation of the Aurora's dark matter drive core.
We're not.
A quantum detonation will occur with a probability of 85.5%. Advise observing a 1 kilometer safety range.
As it said, as long as we stay 1 kilometer away from it, we're fine. When it blows up, we'll be okay. Which, of course, is the Aurora ship on the outside. Let's see here. Okay, so resources. Now, basic materials. That salvaged metal that I collected, that big chunk that's taken up my inventory, it takes up 4 blocks. Well, titanium also takes up 1 little nugget per block, so it's going to turn that big clump of metal into 4 little bitty clumps of metal. So we'll go ahead and do that. Mainly because, well, we need that big clump of metal to be printing the little ones so they can be used for other recipes. Sear quartz, like I said beforehand, for glass. Let's see. Can we pick up? Oh, we can make a battery. We don't need one right now. Don't believe the first thing we want is this O2 tank, which, as you can see, adds a maximum 30 seconds of breathable air, uses 2 titanium in glass, which is the primary thing we need to collect. There we go. Do I have means? No, I didn't collect enough quartz. It's 2 quarts for every 1 glass. Usually, I'll build 2 O2 tanks. Yes, it takes up spot in my inventory, but we'll also go ahead and do a water blocker. What it adds to you outweighs the amount of space it takes up. Now, the O2 tank takes up 4 blocks on you. Unfortunately, for some reason, I'm guessing that they just were not planning on it, or maybe, I guess because it's a tank instead of like a little backpack. I think one of the O2s or one of the suits that you get actually supplies you with air. But this particular O2 tank, do not go on. It has to stay in your inventory slot. You do not have a backpack slot. This is what you're given. So, I don't know where he carries it on him. Who knows? I wish they would have done a backpack thing. You know, kind of like, well, start you off with a smaller amount of carrying capacity, but give you a backpack slot so you can enlarge it or something. But it's still an early access game. You never know. They might do that. As you can see, our water is getting down. Let's see here. Water bottles they gave me are the same as what I created, so go ahead and drink those. There goes all our water. Like I said, the water goes fairly quickly, so we'll definitely have to collect some of those fish. This container, this humongous container, does not go inside your base or wherever you are currently inside of. It actually, as you can see, it's waterproof for a reason. It goes out in the ocean. Pick a spot, put it there, and there you go, Bob Hill. It's a good thing to build it first.
Seismic readings suggest a quantum detonation has occurred
and
in the Aurora's
the
drive core. The central dark matter reactor will reach a supercritical state in T minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6,
we're not outside.
5, 4, 3, 2.
Let's see. I've never actually seen it. Whoa, okay. Well, that explains some of the extra debris that we find up there. Dang. And I'm going back inside for now because I'm sure there's some rats out there. But we'll deplete. So, at any rate, we were saying, well, I'll show you this. I don't think... Oh, that's right, we need a welder. I want to get a welder to see if any of this is repairable, because it says it is. Use welder repel, lifeboat system, damage. These are the power cells that power the pod. The pod itself is powered via solar, so if at nighttime you're using this, you'll notice the power go down and it won't regenerate that quickly. It's at 67 out of 75 right now. It used to go up fairly quickly. I'm guessing I have to repair a pod. So at any rate, I don't know where he is, Mr. Big Guy. Well, let's go ahead and place this down. There we go. These guys should chase away that big one. Yeah, obviously. Alright, anyway, you want to put this near your, base, obviously, at start. As you can see, it adds a little storage thing for you. Good, you can't pick it up. It can place it a little further away. There we go. Just so that way I'm focused on it. Well, let's see. We don't need this many acid right now, so right click, store these. Copper I don't need any right now. I will in a little while. I'll keep the quartz on me. Alright, let's go exploring. I will need a hand scanner soon. You can see these little, there, the solar panel fragments. A hand scanner is used to scan them and basically, oh yeah, he's sticking fairly close to us. We'll go this way. Go back up here. There's some quartz down there. I saw it earlier, but I didn't get it. Actually, America, so these guys will leave you alone as long as you can leave. I might buy it. I'm gonna close it. Oh, no. That's them farting. Yeah, do not go in that cloud. They'll probably die quickly. And, I'm guessing painfully.
New creature discovered.
For some reason, I always put some in the hand. Why? And we need you to come back here for our source of water. Dang it. Oh, you guys are down there. We'll leave you. We'll go this way. Oh, there we go. Two versions. Fast. Yes. We are having a good day today. We've got a few
caution. Rooms. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Yeah, I better go out. Oh wait. Yeah, no, I better go out. I thought those were something else. There's some plants underneath the ocean that put out oxygen or air or the equivalent of something breathable. There's another right here. I swear I saw something else I wanted to grab. We need silver and other things. Copper definitely is good. Pretty much anytime you get the regular metal, titanium, whatever it's called, it's not like a bust. You can get that salvaged. So everything else is kind of just bust. Ah!
Caution. 30 oops. Seconds this, of oxygen this is
why,
remaining.
This is why I can only build two oxygen packs. The constant up and down. Get some come back here. Yes. And I see some salt. Awesome. We'll need that salt later. At least, actually, fairly soon. We have to be careful not to leave the photo, and that's one of the reasons why. That guy over there, he's very nasty.
Caution, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
These glitches. I do not know what some of those fish are the first time I've seen them.
Emergency. 10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
That's weird, those guys. There's no rock holes. Whatever. These guys. Thank you for using them or something. Grab it. That guy is useless. Or at least, as far as I know right now, he is. I cannot do anything. My inventory is full. Beacon definitely helps. Sort of. I'm going to have to create a knife. Some of these things are only harvestable via a knife. But that's okay. Salt. Salt. More valuable than that. And let's
emergency. Get out of here. 10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Let's get out of the ocean here. So we I will not be passing. just creating some space, and I start building things. Because, well, if you build something and you don't have space for it, well, it'll store it. Like, it'll keep it saved. But it's kind of useless. Just so you know, bleach, you need bleach. Now, we need common coral sample. That's easy to get, but in order to get it, we need a knife, and we need silicone rubber for that. Now, silicone rubber, we are going to have to go to a dangerous part to get that, because that's the creek vine seed cluster, if I said that correctly. And, well, somebody is guarding that. The one we ran away from earlier is guarding that. We'll go ahead and turn all this. Titanium ingots basically takes, as it says, 10 of these titanium to turn them into ingot, used for other recipes. Magnesium. I don't think we need any magnesium right now. We do need some water. Since we're at 45%. Hopefully, we'll be able to do a water purifier. I know that's going to take a good amount of resources. Here. Oh, wait. Let's check on our little buddy over here. He did. He's not dead. He's alive and kicking in our storage unit. Well, I'm not sure if that's a glitch or if he just doesn't need to be in the ocean and the aquariums are useless. Or if it's something that they'll patch eventually. Because I would think so. You know, fish here on Earth normally don't live out of the ocean or water. I'm guessing that's just something that they haven't patched yet, which we'll take advantage of. Because this right here, you see, it adds plus 75 to your food. If I eat that now, well, that's kind of useless. So we don't need these guys right now. Yeah, no. If it's decaying, it'll say decayed or something. Better make sure I click. These guys, I... What's it called? Engineering. I forgot what they're used for, but they're used for something. And, oh, yes. Another O2 tank. Now, we will eventually want to get a silica suit, but that's fiber mesh and silver ore. We have yet to run across any silver ore and fiber mesh. Well, that's kind of, if I can find it. I think that's one of the things yet to discover. See it here. I believe it's somewhere in here normally. But at any rate, not all the crafting is shown to you because obviously there aren't just four fish you can eat. There's more. When you use a hand scanner, you build a hand scanner. Use a hand scanner. Here it is. You need a battery. We can build a battery. We have the items. And now we have the power. And yes, that was a really bad pun, but it was there. I had to do it. So, alright. And I silicone rubber. Alright. This thing. Yeah. Oh! I thought. Am I glitching? Or does this spawn new medical equipment to everything? I didn't need to take that out, but... Oh. go to bed in there for now. As a matter of fact, a lot of this I need on me right now. Now, unfortunately, stuff does not stack. You're thinking of the wrong game. And so was I when I first started this. So your inventory or storage space will be taken very quickly. When you start getting into building, we'll definitely have to build some lockers and other things that are used to store your material and equipment. Now, of course, the oxygen tanks, I don't have to do anything with them. They just have to sit in my inventory. I don't have to throw them a hot bar or anything like that. They're fine. No work like that. Now, cancel. Night time. Perfect. Oh, is he dead? Oh, he did. That's why I can't see him. They probably died because those guys farted. And there goes the neighborhood. You know what? You start in a neighborhood with these guys, you do now. They fart, there goes the neighborhood. So just beware of that. Leave the kill. There we go. We'll start with the. These little guys are hard to see. Swim around quick and hike. Luckily, it saves a percentage when you scan something. So it's 20, 30, 40, 50, and I'll stop scanning. Now go back to it. So you don't have to, it doesn't reset every single time. Now, me scanning that, I'm going to have to scan multiple of those little things. So, I forgot what they're called in order to be able to get anything useful. There we go. It says up there 50%. And, I need to go over there. I really do. We need to get a knife. We can't get a lot of things without knives. So we will have to figure out how to get around him. More stuff at scan, more stuff gets added to the encyclopedia. I have no idea what the encyclopedia does. I'm sure that somebody will tell me.
New blueprint acquired.
See, I've got a new blueprint. And of course, it's kind of dumb to do this in the ocean. I can breathe. We're at 50% to get a blueprint for a sea glider. I don't know what blueprint we added, but we added blueprint. And of course, you know, once, obviously, I pick them up, we gain this. I'm guessing that's what happened when you scan other things. Obviously, you can use this swim around. We will swim around this area, but we are going to have to be very careful. Those yellow things down there, I'm going to go left hand corner of the screen, or what I need. Oh, dang. Stay away from him. Oh, dang. And you just took that metal from me. Screw you. And screw your family for stealing my metal. Some of these go places. This one goes home. We want to go there. Have to go there. But I'm a bit of a coward right now. And I'll go back. There we go. The line lagging is me. Alright, my turn. But then again, this is the access to the field of the tower. You just have to make sure that those guys aren't from big guys. Dang it, he just spawned right in there.
New blueprint acquired.
I don't know what he's doing. He's going for that fish right there. We'll let him go for that fish because, well, we don't want to be the target of his teeth, which hurt. Jeez. Up, radiation detector. As you see, you know, we are staying underground longer, underwater longer than beforehand. Very helpful, very useful. I don't know what these things are for, but I have picked them up pretty fast. We'll go ahead and pick them up.
Emergency. 10 seconds of oxygen remaining. I know those little things on there add some type of buoyancy to whatever they attach to. Emergency. 10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Stay fairly close to the surface. That right there is the wreckage piece. We will explore that soon. Generally, then it finds some nice stuff. Luckily, it's very close to the pod. I believe the map that you generate on is a constant. So, that, I believe, will generate near you every single time you generate it. Or at least it has so far. Civil. So yeah, it was silicone. Silicone rubber. Now this thing is huge. I think, yeah, one per. Oh, it used to be huge. Nice. Okay, so this huge thing can turn down into that. Now these are used for other things, as you saw. So you don't want to turn everything into silicone. Dang it, it's three of those vines. Oh well. I don't think we need a lubricant right away. There's our knife. Obviously, yeah. A little history lesson. Now for this we're gonna need a computer chip and a battery. Battery we need that as well. Acid mushrooms, which we have in the chest, and copper, which we have in the chest. Now, the chip is going to be different. Tillet core. Now, most of the coral stuff is what we need the knife for. So we're going to have to go back down for that silver, or we're going to have to get lucky. So, for now, I think we're... good for right now. Air bladder, we're not going to make that right now. I believe that's something that you can use to get to the surface in a hurry. It actually has a little description. Correct, lighter than air for a person of buoyancy. So yeah, it's used to help you float to a place really quickly. Titanium, battery, copper wire, gives you a grab. Tracks the light objects. We might test that out. That wasn't that was not here in previous updates. I don't remember when they included this. I've read up on it a little bit. Sounds interesting. Sounds perfect for fishing, basically. Looks like a good thing now. Check our little fishy guys. Yeah, they're still there. And actually, we're starting to take up the amount of inventory, so we'll make another one of these.
Caution, blood nutrient levels decreasing. Calorie intake recommended.
Basically, I'm hungry. Yes, I realize that. We'll do this guy. And then those guys will turn into water, of course. Right now, that's all we can do. I might have collected enough salt, but I didn't collect any common core ore. Well, obviously.
Vital signs stabilizing.
It's not working yet. Should store some of this here. And we'll go out. Go out here. I know I released some movies because those are obviously. Okay, well, we'll store these things. They took a lot of space. I don't want to turn it into anything right now, so play these things. If you want to change around the hotbar, you can't drag. What you do is hover over it, and you press the number and associate it to that hotbar. So now, one, this knife, which is going to be very handy. Oh, no. I don't see any radiated signs. Or is it just my render distance? That gives us the ability to easily scan that. I dropped this earlier. Pick that up. Switch over to our knife. Collecting some. Weeds. I don't know why we collect weeds, but apparently they're useful for something. Here's the one. Okay, that's the common. So we'll get a little bit more of that. We'll be hungry eventually.
Caution. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
I'll come back and whack you. There's another type of coral. Grab some of that as well. I'm guessing those things migrated somewhere because I don't see any corpses anymore. Now these you can't scan right away, but if you whack them, now they're scannable. And of course, you can pick them up too. Like I said, not sure what adding them to the encyclopedia does, but you never know. Okay, that gives you these things. Blue palm seed. I know that you can be farming in this game. Not sure what that accomplishes yet, but we'll find out. Coral shell. There. Ow. That kind of.
Caution. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Whatever restoring coral shell does, it hurt. Go back up.
Emergency. 10 seconds of oxygen.
Well, while I'm up. Oh, that's why I can't pick up. Ask.
Caution. Calorie deficiency detected.
That. That might be what those squirrels gave you, because here's the table, of course, which is where it's nice to be. All. Back over here. We shall store some of this. Hungry, so.
Vital signs stabilizing.
You don't need any of the spores right now. So we'll store the spores over here. We don't need any of the seeds, but I'm going to have to go in the box because. Alright, anyway. That's an egg. I'm gonna leave it alone. Maybe it's those guys' way of breeding. They looking for something specific. I'm not looking for that guy. But he is giving me a hint that I am heading in the right direction. I'll add the mouse to this. I'll just please help me. It is kind of dark in here. This might be my chance to drive better.
Caution, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining. Emergency, 10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Oh, this is going to be sad. I'm going to die in the vault. I way overthought. Yeah, there we go. Good night, guys. Well, well, you do respawn here. Please tell. Oh, I just lost so much. Oh, well, I guess, now is a good time to, now is a perfect time to just go ahead and cut. I lost so much, I'm going to regather that on camera, because, well, it doesn't look like you drop your things, you die. I lost so much. That was my own fault. It warned me. But we're almost hitting the hour mark. This is longer than I thought I was going to do. I honestly thought I was going to be 30 minutes. I hope I can update this. So, yeah. Let me know if you guys like this. If so, I will continue it, if I get enough likes, and, if I do continue it, I'll pick up after I recollect those details that I, well, just lost. Sad face, guys. It does respawn. Okay, that helps. That helps end things on a lighter note. You don't lose the actual items that you built, I want to say. You just lose the items that you collect. So, at any rate, we'll end that there. Have a good one, guys.